Again, Anthony here, just touching base real quick on my way to a meeting somewhere. You know, we all come with presuppositions. We all have certain things, certain belief systems, certain paradigms that we were brought up with that are entrenched in our mindset, and they're locked in. And one of the most important ones, and the one that affects us the most, is the fact that the map that we have of the world, our view of that map is that it's the right map, and it's the only map that exists. So people have conflicts with each other and experience problems in life when they feel that they're not able to, or they're inadequate to solve a problem themselves in some way. So we tend to view our life through a lens, and that lens can create conflict with other people, you know, because the map is not the territory. And I'm gonna, you know, what does that mean? That's this whole video. I'm gonna try to give you some tools over the next few weeks that if you apply these principles and understand that they work, then you might and will develop a stronger personality, one that's more focused on getting what you want out of life. You know, one of the things I do know is we don't know what we don't know, period. We do not know what we don't know. You know, and again, we view our life through a lens, you know, that we have created over our lifetimes. And, you know, the conclusions that we arrive at, they're based on information that we have been presented with, either through our own thoughts, or more likely through the thoughts of others. You know, we get to select whatever thoughts we choose to work with as they fly through our mind. We are not our thoughts. We are not our beliefs. Those are simply the underlying basis for how we act. And if those thoughts are not aligned with your purpose, then guess what? You are definitely not going to arrive at a destination that you want to be at. That's just a fact. You know, and if we're not reassessing our personal beliefs on a regular basis with new information that's presented to us, then, well, guess what? We're not gonna develop and mature as adults. So, you know, when something new gets presented to you, you need to view it with an open mind. I've been very closed-minded, you know, when I was a younger guy. Now, I no longer am. I view things now from the perspective of, what can I take from this? What can I learn from this? So, you know, the map is not the territory. Let me explain that. When I was a territory sales manager for a very large ice cream company called Edie's Ice Cream, some of you guys probably eat Edie's Ice Cream. It's a multi-billion dollar operation. And I had a huge territory from Montauk to Poughkeepsie. And that was just a huge territory. And you know, we didn't have GPS back in those days. Heck, I didn't even have a cell phone. I had a beeper, you know. So to get to a different location, if I had to drive to Poughkeepsie, I picked the route that was best for me at that moment by looking at a giant map. Yeah, giant maps on the car hood, and I would figure out exactly where I wanted to be. And I would do that on a regular basis. You know, the route that I chose was not necessarily the route that I wanted to take. It could have been based on, you know, the traffic on the radio or something of that nature. You know, it really would tremendously depend on what I was hearing. You know, oftentimes I would have to literally pull over and decide whether or not I wanted to continue on that particular direction, based on, you know, the radio announcement. So, but the map, I realized, was just flat. This is the flat map. It was a representation of reality. It might have shown some green areas. It might have shown some, you know, rivers or streams or a lake, or, you know, a couple of, maybe a toll bridge or something like that. But it was not the territory. When I'm on the ground actually doing the driving, it would never indicate exactly what was in front of me. It wouldn't show any fences that might be in the way, potholes, obstructions, overflowed river. It wouldn't show any of that. Only through my experience of actually doing the drive could I know whether I made a right decision or not. And sometimes I had to make a course correction and whip out that map again and look at it. So the map is just a map. The map is not the territory. You know, it's my perception of the direction I'm going in. There were other routes that could be taken, and other people would have chosen different routes to arrive at the same destination. So when I say the map is just a map, the map is not the territory, it's just that. The map is a representation of reality. So your representation of reality, your belief systems is what you believe is correct. Now there's 9.6 billion people in the world right now, and 9.6 billion people will differ in their beliefs than you 100% of the time. You might agree on certain aspects of certain things. We might agree on politics, but not agree on economics. We might agree on a religion, but not on politics. It's just the nature of human beings. We have developed our own persona, our own belief system based on our experiences in life. So when you're out there and you're trying to figure out if your map is the correct map, and you're deciding that yours is, then you've closed yourself out to any opportunity to develop and grow and maybe eliminate conflict. People develop conflict when their maps differ and their maps, you know, butt heads. That's just a natural instinct, isn't it? You know, another analogy is a religious analogy, that the map is not the territory. You know, you could put five different religious people of different religious persuasions in a room, and all five will try to convince the other four, you know, that theirs is the one. Theirs is the only one. You know, that's just the way it is. You know, orthodoxy comes from the Catholic and Christian faith, but orthodoxy means the one true belief. So if you're practicing orthodoxy, you're practicing one true belief. Your belief is your one true belief, not necessarily the right one, and not definitely not the only one. So if you want to avoid conflict with people, if you want to get to the point where you no longer have to butt heads with everybody that you see, understand that people have differences of opinion. Understand that we have the ability to pull those other opinions into ourselves and not necessarily accept them, but understand where they're coming from, that it stems from their belief systems and their lifestyle and what they've been taught and what they've been told over the years that they've been alive. So that's it for now. Just understand the map is not the territory. Your map is not necessarily the right map, the right route, the right belief. It's your belief. If you end up understanding that, if you could take that away from this particular video, then I've done something special today, because I know I'm convinced that my belief systems are not the only ones out there. And I've learned to avoid conflict by accepting that fact and knowing that we're all individuals and we're all here serving a purpose. We're all traveling down the same road ultimately. We just might, you know, get to the destination a little bit differently. So with that, love you guys, and we'll talk to you later.